Hey guys, my name is Lou. I'm from the channel Lulu Bieber Fall. Lydia has asked me to come over here today and give a few reasons as to why you stay alive. Reason number one, recovery. Reason number two, meeting new friends. Reason number three, your birthday. Reason number four, improving yourself. Reason number five, this one's really important, standing up for yourself. And the last one, which is my reason number five, is making yourself proud.
Somebody, somewhere, is depending on you.
You know what? Maybe they're right. Maybe I'm not good enough. Maybe I am too fat. Maybe I am a whore. Maybe I'm just so sick of everything. It's like anything I do is never good enough. I'm just sick of it all. I just want to end it all.
Close to 800,000 people die due to suicide. Suicide is the third leading cause of death in teenagers. 79% of global suicides occur in low and middle income countries. Ingestion of pesticide, firearms, and hanging are among the most common methods of suicide. Not only does suicide affect families, countries, and communities across the world, it also has lasting effects on people left behind.
Books, movies, people, love, you don't want to miss anything.
Here's one of my reasons for staying alive. So as much as whatever you've got ongoing in your life, many problems, thoughts and feelings that you've got going on in your head, suicide really isn't the answer. Because if you die, you're just leaving behind all your problems and throwing them to your friends and family. And as much as your death is a horrible loss to all your friends and family, you're also leaving behind what you were going through to them. And I'm sure that if you love your friends and family and pets as much as they love you, you really wouldn't want to do that to them. Because to be honest, there is light at the end of the tunnel. There really is. I've been through it all, and I'm slowly coming towards the end of the tunnel. And I believe that there is hope and that there is goodness. After the rain, there's a rainbow, and that's pretty much the same as life, to be honest.
G'day, web surfers. I'm Cowboy, and I'm a quirky Australian girl who loves gaming and entertaining people. You know, life isn't always easy. Everyone's carrying around some sort of baggage. Stress, anxiety, depression, insecurities. And when we turn on the news or we look at our social media and all we're seeing is all the bad stuff in the world, it can make it seem like there's absolutely no hope. But life is about persevering through those struggles, through those insecurities, through those tragedies, through those disasters. For every reason someone may think of to, there are just as many, if not more, reasons why they should keep going. You may not have found your reasons yet, but as long as you keep trying and seeking those answers, there will always be a chance that you'll get better.
Yeah, my name is Happy Black Legends, and I thought I would talk about why you should stay alive. I don't want to cry, sorry. I'm like already starting off like tearing up because I spent from ages 13 until 20 completely suicidal, like really 12 to 20 suicidal. I was thinking about suicide every day. I would make plans, like at one point, like, oh my god, there was periods in my life where I would try like multiple times a week. I was just in a really, really dark place for so long, and I thought that that was gonna be my life, and that's why I was suicidal, because I was like, well, this is just life, and it's like, well, if this is life, I don't want that to be life, right? Isn't that what like depression tells you guys? So for me, what finally stopped that feeling, this is so cheesy, but really, like, I stopped talking negative about myself. That was like the first thing I did. I stopped like repeating everything my brain would tell me. I would say, no, I'm not. Oh, you're so ugly. Oh, you're so fat. Oh, you're so worthless. Oh, you're stupid. You're dumb. You're whatever. You're a bitch. I would go, no, I'm not. I'm not that. That was the first thing I did, and that tremendously helped. The second thing, talking about myself, like I said, I started talking about myself differently, and I just started to try to be genuinely more positive. And I know it's like crazy because I don't believe, like, when you have depression, I never believed any of those, like, you know, Pinterest, Tumblr, Instagram, like, oh, be happy, whatever. But once I started to just think about myself differently and talk about myself differently and talk about my situation in a more positive way, things came to me. I got a job. I started to get more money. I was hanging out with my friends again. I stopped isolating just from thinking and talking about myself differently. So that's, I think, at least for me, that's what I did to not be suicidal. And then reasons to stay alive, oh my god, there's so many. One thing that I like to do is I like to plan for things in the future. So I like to go to concerts. I'll book a ton of concerts and I'll be like, okay, I don't struggle with this anymore, but what I, like last year, I used to like book concerts and be like, okay, you can't kill yourself because you're going to a concert. I mean, and then if you want to talk about reasons to not kill yourself, oh my god, friends and family and things you, I mean, think about all of the albums you'd miss. Think about all of the sequels you'd miss. Think about all the weird little niche interests that you have that you wouldn't be able to participate in. I'm so happy I didn't kill myself in 2019. 2019 was really hard, but I ended up being able to accomplish and achieve so many of my goals. And I ended the year feeling like I grew. And that's amazing. So I just want to say, if you're feeling down or if you're feeling suicidal, I'm so sorry, my heart goes out to you. There's so much to live for, and I know, trust me when I tell you I know, because I literally lived it for 8-7 years of my life. It all sounds like bullshit. It all sounds so, and it's not easy, that's the thing. I still have negative thoughts come to my head, but it's not an everyday thing anymore. It's more of like an every couple of days, or maybe it happens once or twice a day rather than literally all day consistently throughout the day. There's just so much to see and live for, and you know, it is hard to have hope, but it's so important. And I just hope that you give yourself a chance to grow, because growing is amazing. And being able to live and accomplish things, and being able to live and see things, and being able to live and just love, that's an awesome thing. And you shouldn't try to take that away from yourself. You should give yourself the right to experience happiness. So those are some things, those are some tips and things that I've done that have helped me. And I hope you guys are kind to yourselves this 2020, and I hope you guys have a good day. All right, bye.
Hi all, I'm SB Answers from Life of an SB. I do mental health and autism vlogs by advocating and educating you all, as well as taking you all on a journey what life is like for me as an autistic when I'm able, as long as well as some fun and games. My base on it is based on just advocating and educating, as well as creating an awareness and understanding based on autism and mental health, to remove the stigma and stereotyping for both, including basically autism, because autism is still being smashed about a bit. So if you're into any of these, feel free to smash the like and subscribe below on the bottom right hand corner.